Hello and welcome to my updated version of how to program for the Sega Mega Drive / Sega Genesis. To begin with, we're going to need to download some files in order for us to get started. Beginning with the latest version of the SGDK, which can be found on its GitHub page. 7-Zip, a piece of software that we use to extract the SGDK from its archive. Java JRE, a piece of software that's required by the SGDK in order to run. Visual Studio Code, a piece of software that we'll use to write our games in. And finally, the VS Code SGDK template. This is a template that we'll use inside Visual Studio Code to create our games with. I have placed links to all of these files in the description of this video. So let's get started. Firstly, we're going to need to install 7-Zip and extract the SGDK folder to the root of our main drive. For this example, that will be C drive SGDK. Once we're happy with that, we need to install Visual Studio Code. It's a pretty straightforward process, we just follow the setup. Next, we need to install Java JRE. Like Visual Studio Code, all we need to do is follow the setup. After this is finished, we need to set up a new environment variable for Windows. If we go to the Start menu and search for Environment Variables, a tab called Edit Environmental Variables will appear. If we click this, we'll be taken to a new window called System Properties. In this window, we need to click a button called Environment Variables. This will open a new window called Environment Variables. Surprise, surprise! We now need to click New and enter our variable name as GDK. On our variable value as the path to our SGDK using forward slashes. Now we need to extract the VS Code SGDK template to where we want to use it. In this example, I'm just going to extract it to my desktop. Once that is completed, we need to add C support to Visual Studio Code. If we open Visual Studio Code and click Extensions, we'll be presented with the Extensions window. If we search for C++, we should see C and C++ come up at the top of the search. If we click this and then click Install, Visual Studio Code will set things up for us. We've pretty much got everything we need now set up, so we're ready to open the template. If we go to File and Open Folder, we'll be given a window to select our folder from. We need to locate our template folder, which in this instance is on my desktop. Once opened, we'll be able to see the template structure within our Explorer window. If we click the small arrow next to SRC, which stands for Source, we'll be able to see a file called main.c. This is a file that contains our main code loop, and you'll note this already has a sample program in it called Hello Sega World. Now I'll explain how we build a program into a ROM. First, we need to press Ctrl and P. And then type task clean. This function cleans our project, and it's useful for if we need to add new graphics and sound. You don't always need to do this, but I tend to do it when I'm adding new resources to a ROM. Now let's build our ROM. Press Ctrl and P again, and then type task make. This will build our ROM for us. So finally, let's run our ROM. I'm going to open it using one of the most accurate emulators available. Blastem. To run the ROM, go to the template folder and locate the out folder. Inside you'll find a file called rom.bin. With Blastem open, drag the ROM onto the emulator to run it. And there we have it, one working Sega Mega Drive ROM. I hope this tutorial has been useful to you. Please make sure you like and subscribe to my channel. Feel free to support me on Patreon if you wish, and I'll see you in the next video.